Welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe. Kim, we're doing tubes and repositories. Which is this?
I can't believe we've said that twice now, Lee. Okay, this is a repository, a collection, a way for you to find information. Actually, what I have right up right now is a great website that is done by a woman named Karen Seiden, and she produces an email newsletter every Tuesday. It's called Tuesdays with Karen. She also publishes to her blog, and I want to make sure that we gave her credit because she pointed out this site this past Tuesday, and when I had a chance to take a look at it, I went, whoa, thank you, Karen, very much.
She's a great educator. Yeah, I see her involved in some of the things.
Yeah, so Tuesdays with Karen, you can just Google it, and she's got the best way, I think, to interact is just sign up for her email news alert, and every Tuesday, you get one, and she's in that last week.
Join the RSS feed.
Absolutely. Found something really cool and interesting to share. So this week, it happens to be a site called Fotopedia.
That's nice.
Now, we're not going to have to say wiki as much as we did last time, but there is a connection between this service and the Wikipedia, the encyclopedia.
Okay, what's
that's
the
open source. When we talk about
Wikipedia.
Well, the connection is the actual articles themselves are drawn from Wikipedia, but the concept here is that people around the world can take photographs that they have taken in a particular location or of a particular kind of thing, and then associate it with the article that's in Wikipedia.
Oh, okay, that's nice.
So here we have just kind of some random pictures. I'm going to slide down to the bottom down here where you get a look at some of these photographs. This is really a worldwide effort. So what's really cool about this is not confined to the Northern Hemisphere or North America, or, you know, United States and Canada, but you're going to find things from all over the world. So let's take a look. I see a picture here, and I'm just going to – actually, I want to take a look at the Terracotta Army.
Oh, I've seen that. That's
you've seen amazing. That in person, right?
Yes.
So here amazing. Are some great photographs. There are 20 photographs here of the Terracotta Army, and this is very famous, of course, a location in China. So I can use this and I can play this as a slideshow. I can vote for the images that I see. I can find out more information, and I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to start the slideshow. Because what it's going to do is going to take these photographs. So somebody like you, a tourist for instance, was here in China and took all these photos. And then they took the time to say, oh, I want to share these with everybody around the world, and I'm going to upload them to Fotopedia. So it's really simple in order to do this, and you can just, it's completely free to join. And the images themselves, as we mentioned in the last segment, are clearly marked for reuse.
Oh, this is great.
So again, if a student, for instance, were doing a project on you know, on China or the cultural.
This is good because you can see the excavation there.
Right, or the cultural heritage of China. And again, you can go through these one at a time if you wish, and you can pull them all out. If you find one that you really want to take a closer look at, just click on the little information button here. And now it's going to bring that up. Now, here we go. So let's take a look over on the right-hand column. And again, that's what's important for us as digital educators or folks that are working with kids and helping them to understand the rights and ownership of digital media. It clearly says that you can use this picture wherever you'd like, as long as you give proper credit, attribution, to the person who took the picture. You cannot use it for a commercial product.
Do they have a link there that will cite it for you?
And it's right here. So you can
That's
cite
perfect.
That right there. And if I click on that link, it's going to take me over and give me additional information. So it tells you actually who wrote it. And you'll notice these little buttons, again, way cool. I can either download the image, save it to my hard drive, or I can embed it. So imagine that you're working on a project and it's a web-based project, and you want to just grab the code. You don't even have to download the image. You just pull it off of the site here. And again, every image comes with these excerpts from the Wikipedia article that talks about this kind of thing.
So they're probably using an embed code right there.
They are, and basically when the article gets updated on Wikipedia, it's automatically updated in Fotopedia as well. So let's take a look, let's say I want to take a look at alligators. So I'm just going to type that in as my search.
No, you hit the X.
Oh, I did.
Wrong button. That's why you're not the president.
That's a silly place to put that button. All right, I'll just hit hit alligator.
So, oh, this is good.
All right, so again, look at all the different things. So I have articles or that are listed in here by the name of the actual the animal that I'm looking for, but also places where there are found.
Shark Valley.
So there's the Shark Valley. That's down in extreme South Florida.
Just south of US 41.
Mm-hmm. Green Cay Wetlands down in over, I don't know where that is. I think it's in the Bahamas or somewhere. Itchituckney River. Oh, let's go take a look at the Itchituckney River. So I'm going to go ahead and pull that up. And in this case, you'll see that there is exactly one photograph that's been posted about the Itchituckney River.
But an excellent one.
But it's a very nice picture. I like it, so I'm going to go ahead and give it a vote as a positive. And the way this works is photographs are uploaded, but they have to have 5 votes before they go into the Fotopedia. So there's some additional up here. There's a tab that says candidates.
Well, how do you vote on them if?
Well, they go into this.
In
they go into this candidates page over here.
Okay.
And when they're in the candidates page, it's a picture that's posted, and so the community can decide whether this is a good picture, or you know, doesn't really demonstrate what the Itchituckney River is about, or maybe the quality isn't good. But you have to have at least 5 votes before it then shows
up.
Give
this guy a vote.
So give this guy a vote here. That's a good picture. We like that. Lee says good. All right. So, again, that's part of the Itchituckney. So it's now in the encyclopedia. I think we just pushed it over the edge.
We did.
Let's go back over here. And look at that. It's got its 5th vote. And so now it's part of the article in the Fotopedia.
Very good.
So this is a really great site and really a lot of fun. And what I noticed today, Lee, and I pulled up, I do have an account. I noticed when I was looking at this, there aren't enough pictures of West Palm Beach, Florida, where I live.
Really?
So I'm going to go ahead and do a search, and I'll show you how to add images. And it's going to bring this up. And the first thing it does, it shows me all of the sites that have those words in it.
Yeah,
so
and we have
the word
Palm Beach.
Palm. So we have Palm Beach, Florida, which is the town of Palm Beach where the rich people live. Then you have Palm Beach County, Florida, where we all live. But there's nothing for West Palm Beach. But if you look down at the bottom, okay, down at the bottom, you'll see there is a link to West Palm Beach, Florida.
Okay.
And I'm going to go ahead and click on that link. And again, I have to have an account to do this, but it is a free account. There's no charge associated with it. So I'm going to go ahead and say, yeah, I didn't find the article I want, but the one I want is actually West Palm Beach, Florida. So here it goes. It's just zooming right along.
There we go.
All right, so here's my article. So it pulls up the article from Wikipedia, but say, hey, there's no photos. So if this is the article I want to add photos to, I say, yes, add a photo. Now, right now I only have my profile picture in there. Aren't I handsome?
You were.
I were.
You cut your ponytail.
So what I got to do, I'm going to click on this button that says upload pictures.
Okay.
Okay? And I actually happen to have some pictures of downtown West Palm Beach. And these came from the Chamber of Commerce, so I know that it's okay for me to use them.
You do?
I do, because they said that on their website. So
I'm going to go ahead and
upload this picture of a concert that's happening in downtown West Palm Beach. So it looks
Sunfest is coming soon,
slow.
Isn't it?
There we go. So I'm going to go ahead and select it, and I want to nominate that picture, okay, just that one. All right, and I'll say nominate, and now it is in that collection. So when we go to that, and again, just like before, remember, now that that picture is there, I have to get 5 votes.
And somebody has to know enough to go to the candidate
section.
Well,
somebody, again, this is it's one of those crowdsourcing things, so it depends on the economy of the masses. Lots and lots of people, sooner or later, somebody's going to be looking around for West Palm Beach, Florida, and they'll go, oh, gee, there's no pictures. Oh, wait, there's one waiting here to be voted on. So I can add additional photos, same process as you go through, and it does have a limit. I can only put up to 5. But I think it's probably based on the longer you're on the site, the more you upload.
Is that
the
like
more
5 per day or 5 total?
I'm not really sure, but I think that one is going to go out pretty well. And I want to go ahead. Okay, so that one's already in there. If I want to upload one more, I think I have one more of, here's from Ballet, Florida. I'll go ahead and choose that. That is in West Palm Beach. So again, it does take a second or two for that to be uploaded. But sooner or later, that's going to just pop in there. There it is. I check it. I say I want to nominate the picture. Actually, let me go ahead and make sure I got them both nominated, and we'll nominate away. All right, so now if somebody comes in, they look for West Palm Beach, Florida, they'll see that that's there. But again, the wonderful thing I like about this is it's the community aspect of it. The fact that you can get all these great photos that people have uploaded. We've seen
already.
The
quality is awesome.
The quality is awesome. So in the few minutes we've looked at this, we've looked at photos from China. We've looked at photos from South Florida. And the more you look, the more things you'll find.
Looked at alligators?
We did. We looked at alligators. So again, let's think of a little bit.
This one is strictly photography. It's not video.
It is. It's no video, no audio. It's strictly photographic. So let's do another one. Let me go to another favorite of our friends. We'll take a look at the manatee. Okay. And manatee, of course, is that animal that lives in South Florida and the Caribbean, and it's kind of endangered here. And so you have the main article, and I think we'll go there this time instead of looking at the place. And so, again, imagine that you're teaching a lesson on the manatee. Now you've got really great, high-quality photos. And you can, as we said before, you can click through these one at a time. Oh, look, a baby.
Yeah.
All right.
Nice
so
fish there, too.
You can get those. Yeah, big old bass. Don't get excited there, Jeff. All right. So you can look at the photographs of the manatees. Your kids can save the photographs
and there are
of the
some
manatees.
Candidates.
Maybe there's one drawback to this system, Lee.
Okay, what is it?
The fact that with an encyclopedia article, and all the photographs right there, I think there might be a little bit of danger with plagiarism. So
probably
you wanna,
not.
No, probably not. No. Maybe once.
They would cite this as a reference.
Exactly. That's what you would want to do.
And paraphrase from all their resources.
Right. So if you're a parent at home helping your children with this, we don't copy and paste the text.
No.
We read the text. We know you have permission to use the pictures, so that's great. So use the pictures as a way to illustrate your original work that draws on references that you find online.
Should we tell them that a lot of the teachers have these little programs that will check for plagiarism?
You know, as a matter of fact, when teachers are suspicious about that, there are programs that do that. But
put
you know,
in a few
an easy
words.
Way to do it, Lee, is to just
Google
copy
it.
Part of the student essay that you are a little bit suspicious of, paste it into a Google search, and you'd be amazed how accurate it will be. So, you're going to be looking for words that, kids, if you're a fourth grade student, you're probably not going to be using.
Yeah, I see some $25 words in that.
Yeah. But again, what a great way to do this. And if you are a photographer.
You know what I'm hooked on with this?
What are you hooked on?
The candidates tab.
The candidates. Are there any candidates that are waiting? Nope.
So all of their pictures have been approved.
Yeah, they've all been approved. So here's one we'll pick up randomly. And again, you can, just kind of scroll through and just to, now here we go. This is the United States, which currently has 109, that's a great picture of the Statue of Liberty.
These are all great pictures.
Really, really well done. But there's 197 photos, and I want to go, let's go to the.
65 votes on that?
Yeah, let's go to the biggest version of this, and now you get a real feel for just how good this is. In terms of the quality of the photographs themselves.
That is awesome.
Isn't that great? Really great color. And again, if you're studying the United States or just studying,
Horseshoe Bend
of the, so that's part of the Grand Canyon out there.
This is a really great repository.
Isn't it great? It's really
it's
got
free.
A lot of beautiful photographs, from all over. And again, a lot of candidates in the case of this big category. More candidates.
Okay,
so,
I did notice that before. It shows you the number.
It does. Right up in the little tab, it'll tell you the number of candidates that are waiting.
Okay,
so you can go
fantastic.
Through and have a look at those, and let's put a few votes in there while we're at it.
Okay.
But photopedia.com, very easy to get to, great website, and we highly recommend it.
We'll be back with more.